Howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here and I want to talk to you today. This is my motivational, uplifting type broadcast, but I'm kind of going to be mean too. But mean, it's kind of like being mean because I love you, okay? Not being mean because I'm just an ass, but which I am, but I love you and I want to help you. And there are vendors out there struggling. Two that I've heard about, today is Tuesday, and two this week so far, two that have contacted me that are struggling. One actually sent me a, hey, Bulldogs Hot Dogs in the house. Ben Dean's here. Love that freaking little Harley Davidson skull thing you got. Anyway, I wanted to tell you that I am it overwhelms me because, first, let me tell you this. Some of you know, we have a blog, right? Well, these videos end up getting shared more than the people that are watching live, but they get shared and then people go over to the blog and we can tell from the stats that it increases in the next like 6 to 7 hours after a live show. The blog traffic increases and then you see where people have gone over and it's free information, but in the blog, there's a wealth of information for you. I'm talking, and it's overwhelming. I know you're going, oh my gosh, but I could never go through 900 articles and 500 videos and blah, blah, blah. And you don't have to. And thanks for all y'all for joining me. I'm going to go through everybody here in just a minute. If you have a question while we're doing this live broadcast, please add it. But hear me out first. I want you to hear this out because you may be making this mistake and don't even know it. You may be doing something wrong that you could change just the smallest little thing and increase your income, multiply your income. And that's what I want to talk to you about. I know my camera's up here, my screen's down here, and I put it on black and white. I can change that because I'm cool. Look at that. Booyah. Representing with the hot dogs today. So anyway, I want to share something with you that two calls this in the past 2 days. One guy calls and asks if I would do a cart critique. He had watched some cart critiques on our blog. It's where somebody sends me video or photos of their cart and surroundings. And then I pick it apart, figure out anything that I could see, noticeably see, that would prevent a customer from coming up or help them in adding more customers. Sometimes some of them are really good and they send me photos from way off and they give me a Google map overview of where they are and kind of thing. But the gist of it is I need to see the overall picture. I don't do these a lot. Usually I charge for them, but I've done several for free for years, right? And I've done them. This person found some of the ones that are free on the site. If you're Vendors United, all of them are in there for free for you in the group area. But asked me if I'd do it, and I said, sure, I'll do it. Really struggling, doesn't have any extra money, doesn't know what to do. And I said, listen, I'll get to it. I'll just give me some time, and I'll get to it. Well, the other night, I got up in the middle of the night, couldn't sleep, and whole nother deal. But I got up and I said, you know, I'm going to just do some emails and answer some. So I went to that. I'd starred that email and started going through the photos. And the first thing I noticed was the appearance. The appearance of this vendor. And it's always a hard one because, you know, I don't want to be, I mean, I like being an ass, but I don't like being an ass to hurt your feelings. I'm just sarcastic. I don't want to hurt your feelings, but I also don't want to not say anything and hurt you because of my inability to be clear and honest with you. This was a tricky one for me, and I waited till the next day and talked to my wife, and I was like, I don't know how to say this. You know me, I read her what I wrote. I saved it in an email draft. I said, here's what I said, and she kind of said, well, you could probably take out that part or this part. And, you know, you sound a little brash. The gist of it is, though, the gist of it is he looked nasty. He looked nasty. His wife looked nasty. They looked nasty. And I don't mean that in a bad way. Like, but they, my grandpa used to say, boy, you know, I'd come home from work and I'd be in the tobacco fields. I don't know if y'all ever did that, but you come home, you got black tar stuck to you with dirt. It's nasty, right? I've worked in the sunflower fields and black, just nasty, sand blown, nasty, sweaty, gross. And my papa would go, boy, you look like you just fell off a turnip truck. You know, because turnips you dig up and you're messing with the dirt. And you look, you know, like you're a grave digger back before they had shovels. So, you know, rode hard, put up wet too many times kind of look. Well, I had to word it in a way, but the gist was yucky shirts. And you don't need your logo on your shirt. Great if you have one. But it is not going to be the difference between you and success, having a logo or not. But what is going to make a difference is how you look. Well, then today, another vendor working at a good spot. I'm talking a good spot. Ready to throw in the towel, done, wants to be completely done with this business, ain't making it, can't make it, barely making $100 a day. I don't want to do all this for $100 a day, and I don't blame them, right? Now, obviously, they're out there for about 3 hours during a lunch period, but the point is they're in a good spot. They should be making triple that. So, again, I find out pictures, surroundings, the whole deal. Again, looks like crap. Looks like crap. You do not have to be in a three-piece suit. You do not have to have an Armani apron. But you need to be clean. You need to have clean fingernails. I know you got gloves on, and I know you want to grow out your cocaine snorting finger real long, but what my point is, don't. Be someone that is a stigma destroyer, somebody that gets rid of the vendors already have a bad stigma, and we didn't do it. We ain't the ones that caused that. But there is a stigma. And about 3 years ago, we figured this out and we started saying, hey, when you do your business name, add the word catering to it. Hillbillies, hot dogs, and catering, right? And even though we didn't know at the time that that would turn into a whole nother business and we'd make even more money, which is what happened. That's the honest to God truth. We wanted to change the stigma. Well, it doesn't help when you have vendors out there going, hey, what can I get you? Sitting down. This vendor, no joke, sent me a video that someone took. I assume one of his kids or something took it and put it on Facebook. Showing dad working. Dad is sitting in a freaking lazy chair, like a lawn chair that you take to the beach, one of them $12 Dollar General chairs, which I don't care about. Okay, that's not the point. But he's sitting in it, waiting on customers, leg crossed back like this, smoking a cigarette. Now, I love to smoke. I quit about 2 months ago, but I still don't have a problem with people smoking. Don't smoke at your freaking cart. Don't. I used to constantly walk away from my cart or get down and smoke. You know, I'd hotbox. You remember hotboxing in high school, going to the boys' bathroom and suck it down. You had a red cherry on the end of your cigarette that long. That's what I'd do next to my cart when nobody was around real quick so I could get some smoke out, you know, get my nicotine fixed. Well, don't smoke, number one. Fingernails clean. Hands clean. Shirt. Go buy Dollar General, okay? I still do this. I still go to TJ Maxx, Marshall's, and go get me a sack of shirts for $15. Gives me 5 shirts or something, $3 a piece. Or if you're ever out of town in a touristy area, which I live near one, okay? I can go right down the road and they got 3 t-shirts for $10 and they'll put any emblem, you know, they got all these stick on graphic things, the iron on shirts, you know, they'll do for you 3 for $10. You get to pick a rooster or a cross or whatever, a gun or whatever on there. And I just buy mine plain. Yeah, I'll take three of those large. Well, look good. I'm going to go through some other people's tips and tricks people have been sharing right here in the comments. Because if you're doing this wrong, don't take this wrong. I want you to be successful. You're hurting yourself, not to mention us, if you look like crap. Crap. I came from white trash. Trailer park white trash. I still bend that way. It's where I feel comfortable and at home. But when I'm serving, I have a clean shirt on. I have clean pants on. I even carry an extra shirt in my truck in case I spill something on it. I know I have an apron, but sometimes I have just the waist apron on, and I have been known to spill some chili. I've been known to toss over the ladle into the chili and it splash up and hit me in the arm. Well, now I look like crap. Not to mention the area around your cart. The area around your cart cluttered with trash. And I had a vendor. This is no joke. You can mark my words. We had this guy on the show, the radio show, Hot Dog Vendor Radio. He's on the show and he's telling me that there's trash ever up and down the street next to me. It ain't mine. I ain't picking it up. I ain't cleaning it up. Well, you're hurting yourself, moron. I'm saying that in a nicest, kindest, I love you, moron way. You, by being lazy and not picking up the trash that ain't yours, and if you've had kids, you do lots of stuff that ain't yours, okay? You didn't make the mess, but you end up cleaning it up. Parents, we're right here, right? But other people throw stuff out the window. Your parking lot may look a mess. I remember one time I arrived at a parking lot and it looked like a styrofoam factory had exploded. What happened is somebody had dumped something or trash had fell out of their truck or something, but a piece of styrofoam, maybe out of a TV wrapper, I don't know, but a big piece, crumbled up to a blue million pieces. It looked like it had snowed. That would go over great if it had just snowed, but it hadn't. And it wasn't going to. It's about 90 degrees. It looked like crap. I cleaned it up. Was it my responsibility? No. Don't we have city people to clean that up? Yes. Is it going to hurt my business today? Yes. So what do I do? Keep my area looking good. We had a vendor send in his cart critique, and he's on the side of a road on dirt. Okay. Real dusty, dirty area. I gave him the suggestion of getting outdoor carpet, indoor-outdoor carpet, you know, that looks like fake grass, real short pile, okay? And I said, go get you a piece of that. He goes, it's real expensive. I said, no, it ain't. Go to Lowe's, see if they have any remnants. He found a remnant. Wasn't even a cool color. It was like burgundy or something, mauve or something. But eventually he got a green one. But I've got vendors doing that with tan ones. I have a tan one. If I'm ever vending somewhere where it's dirty, I'll put that down. Even on a concrete asphalt or whatever, it looks better. It looks like, hey, I give a crap. I want you to know I'm going to serve you, and I've made my area as clean as possible. I keep my fingernails clean, my hands clean, my face clean. I do that. Now, y'all know me. I do this whole beard thing, grow it out and look like a retard, right? I love it. It's the hillbilly white trash in me. But here's what I want to tell you. It hurts business. It hurts business by having that long thing or scraggly like this or hairs growing out your ears or your nose hairs growing out. It looks nasty. People notice that stuff and they may like your food and they may eat it once. But don't you want them to come back? Don't you want when they go, hey, did you see that new vendor down there in front of the Ace Hardware? And you go, yeah, I saw him. I filmed for y'all last summer a vendor who set up in front of an Ace Hardware. That's why that brought to my head. Set up in front of the Ace Hardware lawn chair like this. And half the time, I kid you not, he's asleep. I even posted up a video clip of him here on Facebook. Aggravates me. To see if you don't have if you're just too tired and go, I don't want to do it, then don't go out that day. Just don't go out. Yeah, you'll miss that $100. But I'd rather you miss that $100 than hurt all of us and hurt your business in the long run. Because in the long run, if you'll just work the days you want and you go out there at 110%, giving it your all, you're ready for the day. You look like somebody that didn't just fall off the turnip truck. You look good. You're presentable. You're clean cut, clean shaven. And you go and you are smiley. You have to have a good attitude. You have to smile, be happy, tell some jokes. If you don't know jokes, Google jokes. Google icebreaker jokes. They actually have lists of those for people that are what's the word for it? When you have a sense of humor impaired, okay? Some people have a drier sense of humor. Some people have none. It doesn't stop you from making lots of money. A smile will get you a long ways. A smile. Watch how you feel right now. If I look at you like this, or I look at you like this. You see them dimples? That's how I got my freaking wife. I'm telling you, if you feel good, that feel good resonates. If you look good, that look good resonates. It goes out there. It helps other people. It makes them feel good. They feel like everything's good around them, and then they buy, and at least if they were going to buy either way, at least they'll tell people. There's a positive exchange instead of that was a good hot dog, but that boy looked rough. Did you see him scabs on his arm? I understand. Last year, y'all saw some of the pictures. My arm I still have scars. I got swole up with poison ivy. I'd never gotten that before and got eat up with it. Okay. Cut my finger from a ring. I mean, it just swole up and popped. I had to go to the ER at some point. I mean, it was a mess. You don't go out there like that. Guess what they make? Guess what they make? I went and did it was a fundraiser deal. And my arm I was already on antibiotics and it was going down, but it still looked like I had been through a meat muncher thing, you know, one of them old timey meat grinders. My arm looked horrid. And I got one of those compression sleeves because that's all I could find. And it was thin. And I put it on and it covered it. But I put gauze on under it and then put that compression sleeve because I didn't want it to look nasty or, you know, have any like seep through. If you have a cut, band-aid it up. And now they make band-aids that look like skin. You can even double, triple wrap it. Make yourself look presentable. If you get 5 mosquito bites and you scratched them all night long and they look like hell, cover them up. Cover them up. Do something, okay? Don't look crappy is the bottom line, okay? Don't look crappy. That's all I had for my rant there. So now what I'm going to do is go through and talk to everybody that's here real quick. Give a shout out. Ben Dean's in the house. Glad you're here, Ben. EJ's here. Doggone it, hot dogs. Howdy, the Daily Dogs is here. Ben, I see you in black and white. Yes, I was in black and white at the beginning of the show. And I can do it right now again. Look at that. I'm black and white again. It's like being in the 60s. Ben, missing you, Ben. Bubba. Martin John, hey Ben, Josh Woods in the house, Roger and Vicky Carroll, hey Ben, MR Dogs in the house, MR Dogs, MR not, OSAR, CM, that's a whole nother story for you. Alpha Dogs here, KCDC, Kanawha City Dog Company here, I hope I pronounced that, I like that name, Kanawha, sounds Indian. Hello Ben, hi everyone, I don't know if Indian's the right term, I know that politically correct and maybe Native American. I don't know, but I'm 23%. Whatever that means to anybody. Hot Dogging It is here. B&T Catering's here. Catering for You. Ken Packer's here. David Yanito's here. Yes, Ken, great leadership. And Josh Woods in the house. Has Ben started? I've been able to watch the last, I haven't been able to watch. Yeah, Ben started. Anthony, how long does it take to receive your book after it's been ordered? Usually 4 to 5 days, sometimes 7 to 10, depending on the postal service. It goes through media mail. And so I don't know, but if it's been longer than 10 days, let me know and I'll find out for you. T.I. Edmonds, Gypsy Dogs and Catering in the building. See, I love this when I see these names and it says dog and catering. Even like Kanawha City Dog Company, City Dog Company. Company gives it that extra bit. I would love it if it said catering with it, but I'm not trying to get you to change your company names, but you can always DBA. DBA is free, doing business as. So you can be Kanawha Dog Company and then or City Dog Company and then be Kanawha Hot Dogs and Catering Company as your DBA. It's easy. Monster Burgers in the house. Glad you're here, Garrett. Ken Packer, I wear nice shorts, bright colors, polo shirt, always wiping down things, even if it's not needed. Ken, yes, we talked about this last night on the Private Vendors United show. Even if it isn't needed, even if it's not needed, do it, do it, do it. I don't need to wash my hands all the time, but sometimes I just do because people see it. And it looks good. So is there a value actually in the cleanliness? I've had these gloves on. I ain't touched any money with it. What's the problem, right? Why not? Go, hang on just a second. I want to wash my hands real quick. Everybody will be, nobody will go, oh, I'm leaving. That idiot's going to wash his hands and tie up the line for another 8 seconds. No, they're going to be like, oh, look at him. Washed his hands, got on a fresh pair of gloves and started going again. You'll win. You'll win. I want that shirt, Ben. Look at that. Look at that. I love it. I love it. It's just a simple hot dog shirt. Just simple. Somebody messaged me the other day when I had it on a week or two ago, said that's ketchup on the dog. I said, no, that's sriracha. Anthony, it took about 4 to 5 days to get mine. You're going to love it. David, don't pick your nose. Yeah, that's another one. Don't pick your nose. Hey, Ben, shout out from California, man. Steve Marino's in the house. Steve Marino, one of my good friends, passed away of cancer. His last name was Marino. He was from New Jersey. I wonder if you're kin to him. Anthony Garcia ordered it last Monday and still waiting. That's a long time to wait. Send me find your receipt. And email that to me, forward it to me. That way I can have them look for it and find out what the deal is. Because it may have got missed. Something may have happened. Let's see. Check it out. Stuffed Gourmet Foods. I've learned a good bit from you, boss. Thank you, Stephen Delano McFarlane. That's from Stuffed. I like that name, Stuffed. Stuffed Gourmet Foods. And I like how you spelled it. If you're fugly, Steve, you know what? It doesn't matter. Personality. Tell me this, honestly. Have you ever met a homeless person? Like being at a train station, airport, somewhere, big city, visit them, something. Meet a homeless person. Turns out that person, like, all of a sudden you go from seeing them as a homeless person to seeing this human who has this story and they're well-spoken and everything changes. Well, all because you got to know them a little bit, and it could only be 15 seconds not got to know them. Things change in our head. Well, the look of you doesn't really matter. I know an ugly vendor in North Carolina, ugly. I'm just telling you he's ugly. He'll tell you he's ugly. He's got a whole like a thing he does. Okay, I'm not even going to tell you what he does because I'll give you some examples of what other people do. Like we have a guy that does a unicycle and has a bow tie. There's a guy that does, looks like an engineer on a train. Okay. There's another guy that looks like a boat captain. There's a guy that does military. He helps military vets who are wounded warriors, and he has them come in and they help and work. And then he donates a portion of his proceeds daily to his local wounded warriors, kind of like Michael Wood does and Doug's Dogs. These are people that have created a little personality, a persona for their business. Looks don't matter. Have you seen half the movie stars? They don't look as good as me and you. We should be movie stars. Corey, oh, doggies is in the house. Love it. I love when Corey can make it. The Great American Hot Dog Stand, hey, from the side of the road. Look at there. That's, you know who the Great American Hot Dog Stand is, don't y'all? Mark Lawler, he's in the house. Y'all got to hear a lot from him last night. He kind of ran the show last night on the private show. Jenny Weber, Yeller Dogs here. Hey, by the way, there's a link up above if you want a free course. Free. Absolutely. No strings attached. Free. Grab it. If you're new or if you're used. Okay. What I mean by that, if you're already vending, I got something for you. And if you're not vending, I got something for you. Both ways. Take it. Like it. If you don't like it, give it to somebody that might. It's good information. Double D's Grill from Maine. What's up, Ben? Jeff Daniels, thanks for being here. Glad you're here. Jay, first class, period. Hey, Ben, I was wondering if it was a good idea to sell hot dogs at kids' PAL football games. Are there rules to this? Some cities do have rules to it, but it's typically pretty easy. If you go back through the shows at learnhotdogs.com, you'll see Jason Brown. He hooked up with his local community. They were sick of running the concessions. They ended up hiring him to do them all at the games. Same deal for this. In fact, last year, one of them got a YMCA gig. They didn't want to run their own kitchen. There's so many of these types of things. You'll need there's probably a process, but it's probably easy. Okay. You're taking workload off of them. So when you approach those kinds of things, do not approach them as they're doing you a favor. Even though you may perceive it that way, you're doing them a favor is the truth. That's the facts. You're going to be a benefit and asset to them. So treat it that way. I've had people stop because they see me cleaning my cart. There's Corey Lawrence. Oh, doggies. Yes. See you cleaning your cart. See you cleaning up. And if you've seen any of the videos Corey's done, everything always looks nice. He's not got a mess. Now, there's times when you get busy and you've got some ketchup mustard here and there. Listen to how easy this is to fix. Can you give me about 6 seconds? I want to wipe this down real quick. You grab your sanitized rag out of your sanitized little bucket and you wipe down real quick. Throw it back down in the bucket. Rinse your hands off. Wash them real quick. Throw on some new gloves. How can I help you? I'm talking just bam, bam, bam. You will go. It will earn you miles more than you think. You might not get an immediate result that you think. Like, oh, that was cool. He just cleaned his cart. I'm going to give him $20 extra. No, probably won't happen. But what will happen is what you just did there, other people saw. Some people may have not have said a word, but they'll tell 1,600 people. They'll tell 7 people at church next Sunday. Yeah, I saw that vendor down there. Oh, my God. That one with all them leprechaun symbols and stuff, old doggies or something. He's cleaning his cart. Just cleaning it. No reason. That goes a long ways. Anyway, Steve, thanks for the kind words. It's been a few years ago, but your name reminded me of him. I hope y'all enjoyed this. I hope it helps you. I will be back tomorrow because I have something else I want to talk to you about. I don't know what time I'll be doing it tomorrow, but let me tell you real quick what my yellow pad got filled up, started using the backs of the sheets, and my wife is right now going out to Staples to get me some more yellow pads because I run slam out. I use these. These are like this is like more than my computer, my yellow pads. I barely read my writing. It's the bifocals getting used to these. Insurance. I got some stories for you tomorrow. I'm going to help you out, but I'm going to tell you how a simple insurance policy will make you more money and a lot more money. I'm going to give you a valuable tip tomorrow. I was reminded of it today by a dear friend of mine who's a vendor. His name's Donnie. He's freaking awesome. And he's in North Carolina. And does multiple things in concessions. But he reminded me today, I'm going to share that with y'all. I cannot wait to see you tomorrow. I appreciate you being here. I'm going to read this last one. I make gourmet hand pies. I sell at craft beer bars and breweries. One of my top sellers is braised beef short rib with black garlic. That would be all up in my alley. Never heard of black garlic. Going to Google that in just a minute. Never heard of that. Thank you for all the information you've given. Very helpful. Stephen Delano, Delano McFarland, thank you for being here. And I love that name again. Stuff it is kick butt. Love it. The get stuffed. I love that. Get stuffed. Y'all have a good one. I'll see you tomorrow. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you got some value from this. And I hope if you're unshaven, you get shaved. I hope that if your fingernails are dirty, you clean them up, shorten them up, look presentable. Go get you some $3 white t-shirts. Go get some bright red shirts. Brighter colors tend to make people happier. So go figure, there's actual colors that have an effect on our little noggins and the gray matter in there. So look into that. Have fun. I'll see y'all. Love you. And I'll see you all tomorrow.